Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. In today's video, we are going to demonstrate the Zeeman effect experiment. This kit belongs to different parts, and by combination of different parts, you can easily detect and study the Zeeman effect experiment. So before that, I will explain you the basic theory of a Zeeman effect experiment. So the Zeeman effect experiment is the splitting up of a spectral lines atoms when they are placed in a magnetic field. In 1896, it was observed by Zeeman that when an atom is placed in an external magnetic field and then excited, the spectral line it emits when it is in excitation process are split into several components. So this is basically called the Zeeman effect, and which can easily indicated, and we can also get this through this experimental setup. So I will now explain you the different parts of this setup, and we will do the Zeeman effect experiment. So this is the basically Zeeman effect experiment setup. The order code for this setup is 19204401.3. You can order this by using this code and by querying on the Tesca's website, which is www.tesca.in. So now I will explain you the different parts of this setup. So we will start with the digital Gauss meter. So this is a digital Gauss meter which provides the magnetic field generated by the electromagnet. You can observe the magnetic field. We are also providing the test probe or hole probe with this. So this is a hole probe. This will detect the magnetic field present through the and the intensity on the magnetic poles. So we will use this probe to detect the magnetic field, and this is the range selector here for different ranges, and this is the on off toggle switch, and this is the zero adjuster knob. So the when value of the magnetic field is around not around the zero, you can adjust this value to zero to make the accurate results. Now moving on, this is the constant current power supply. The maximum power output current output from this supply is about 4 amperes. These are the positive negative terminals. This should be connected with the electromagnets. This is the on off switch of this supply. The resultant current at which the supply is working will be shown at this meter. Now moving on, there is a Zeeman effect power supply setup. So this setup supplies the camera LED supply and the discharge tube supply. So this is the mercury and argon discharge tube. So this discharge tube will be glows when we power on the supply with this constant current source. So we will connect this supply, this discharge tube to this both of the point. You can connect any of the point to any terminal because this is a AC power supply source. So this is the on off switch of this power supply, and this is the LED on off switch for the camera section, and this is the connector of the camera supply. This camera supply will furtherly connected to this optical bench source. So this is the optical bench here. At this, the different components are installed. Now I will explain you the electromagnets. These are the electromagnets of high power electromagnetic source. The discharge tube is placed in between the electromagnets. So when we energize the electromagnets, the discharge tube also faces the magnetic values, magnetic field as well. Moving on, here it is a monochromatic narrow band interference filter which have the central wavelength of 546 nanometer and HPW of 8 nanometer. So this will act as a monochromatic source for our experiment. Now moving on, there is a polarizer. This is the polarizer lens with a plane polarized lens. This setup is installed with this mechanical arrangement on this optical bench. Now moving on, there is the Fabry-Perot etalon. This etalon is the most important part and the very fragile part, so always protect it and carefully use. When you use, be sure that you are using this very carefully. Now moving on, there is a telescope. This telescope sees the waveforms and the fringes from the Fabry-Perot etalon. And moving on, there is a camera which is CCD camera. This camera captures the images from the telescopes, and there are different micrometers placed to adjust all the value in horizontal and as well as vertical direction. Both the XY direction are provided here. Now moving on, here are the electrical connection setups. So this is the power supply of camera section. From this you can power supply to the camera, and this is the camera power supply and other connections, and this is the LED supply that was connected to the optical bench that I have explained earlier, and this is the video output of the camera. The camera output will be going to the LED TV here, at which we will try to reach out the fringes from this experiment. So this LED output will connected to the video output channel of the television. So this television are also provided with this kit. We are also providing an extension to give the all supplies from one place, so you have to not worry about the different supplies arrangement. Now we will power on the setup and try to do the experiment. For this we will follow the user manual procedure given in the user manual to verify and to set up the experiment to get the fringes, and then we excite the mercury atoms to the find out the Zeeman effect. So first we will turn on the digital Gauss meter. Before that I will turn on the extension board supply, and we will turn on the digital Gauss meter here. Now right now you are seeing the value of this Gauss meter is in the negative, so we will use this test probe holder and open the test probe cover. And connect this test probe, hole probe to the hole probe holder properly, and place this hole probe holder and in between the proper center of the electromagnets here. Now we will power on the electromagnet by this power on supply. This is on the mercury tube, and also we will on the current source power supply. So now we will on the current source. So this will give the current to the electromagnets and electromagnet charges. So tighten the properly adjust the both the poles of south or north of the electromagnet, so the distance between the poles on the both the sections will be remain the same here like this. Make sure the both the parts have the same distance through the from the mercury tubes. Now see the hole probe, if it is showing negative value, turn the hole probe to 180 degree and in the proper so after adjusting the probe properly vertical in between the magnetic field, you will observe the value is about 15 at the zero current. Now adjust this value to zero. So with this voltage adjuster and the zero adjuster switch. So right now the value is zero. Now as we increase the electromagnet's current here with this current increasing probe, you will see the magnetic field also increasing around the magnetic poles. The Gauss meter is showing the readings. So this is the lower selective range here you can see. Into 10, and this is the into 1 section. So this is the how the both the Gauss meter and constant current source working in this mode. Now we will set up the all arrangements given in the assembly. So proper try to find out the fringes. For this we will first adjust this plane polarized lens near about 5 centimeters to the monochromatic source, and by neck dive we will try to see the so this polarizer need to be in the proper focal length. After that you will adjust the fabric pad etalon. So this etalon's adjustment is very crucial. So while working with this etalon, be very careful because this is the very fragile equipment. This can be damaged by non-proper use. So properly adjust the etalon and observe the slit type of pattern through the polarizer by neck die at this point. And the slit pattern will be showing at a comet tail like structure. So this comet tail like structure should be coincide in one slit, and this slit will be observed through the telescope, and the telescope's output should be observed by the camera. So you should need to adjust and practice many times to find out the waves properly from this. So this is a very patient, the students need to be very, very patient and practice more and more time to do the experiment to find out the fringes pattern. And then after you find out the fringes, then you will energize the after you find out the fringes on the LED screen, you will energize, as you energize the electromagnets by increasing the current, you will find the fringes are splitting in several spectral lines. So this was affecting the Zeeman effect. Now after setting up the experiment, and many times you will practice the experiment, so this is not right now are the proper fringes, but when you practice the experiment and do the different optics, must sure that you work in the dark room, because this is the optics experiment, so this required the very dark room to perform the fringes experiment properly. Now these are the basic fringes that we have try out in the little time and get the fringes type. Now as I increase the current from of the electromagnets here, you will see the effect of the Zeeman effect, that the fringes were now started glowing blur as I increase the electromagnets power. You can see the fringes are going to blur. So as I increase the electromagnets power, the fringes spectral line has been split in the several lines, and these several lines are so many that the fringes are right now showing as a blur fringes. You can also see the different polarized fringes by changing the polarizer positions. So that's how you do and study the Zeeman effect experiment on this kit. So that's how we try to do setup, and just video to explaining how to set up the Zeeman effect experiment setup and try out. We try out to find out the fringes, but these fringes are not proper. You can do many practice and patiently working on this kit, you will able to find out the proper circular fringes and proper sharp and accurate fringes with this kit. So this kit perform all the experiment properly of a Zeeman effect this kit shows. So while working with this kit, if you want any support from us, you can contact to Tescar Technologies Private Limited. Thank you for today.